Hello, comrade! This is Geralt, and I welcome you to part 3 of A New Republic is Born, the first campaign for workers and resources Soviet Republic. If you want to check out the first couple of videos, there is a link to the playlist in the description of the video. We just finished a few important research tasks after building the first university and party headquarters. Unfortunately, we also had our first building falling casualty to fire, and I don't want to let that happen again. And I don't even know how I missed it while I was playing. I saw it later when I was editing the video. And we lost our volleyball court, which we have to rebuild now. Speaking of that, to prevent this, we have to go to the next stage of our objectives, and that is emergency, because I'm pretty sure that fire handling is going to be here. So let's go. Build facilities that will deal with emergencies in our republic. Yep. That'll be great. Greetings, comrade. I'm Kirill Petrov, here to guide you through the importance of hospitals in the Soviet Republic. With a focus on public health and well-being, our hospitals stand as pillars of care and compassion, safeguarding the vitality of our nation and its citizens. Awesome. Let's continue, comrade Petrov. The hospital serves as a crucial hub of healthcare in the Soviet Republic. It is essential that citizens can access it, but it's okay if some of them have to take a transit vehicle to get there. Be sure to set up regularly running transit lines to give everyone access to the hospital if it can't be reached by everyone on foot. Like in the real world, build a hospital. Okay, let's build our first hospital then. Also, emergency is in the same area here. We have fire stations and hospitals in the same place. And we have hospital one, small clinic. It's tiny. Has up to 5 doctors and 5 workers. The medium hospital or the normal hospital has 30, maximum 90 patients. And the large one is 3 times the size. And 10 times more expensive. Oh, wow. Okay, I honestly don't think we need even the normal hospital now. But I think we are going to start expanding this city soon enough. So let's build that one here. Ooh, do we have access to everyone? Oh, no. If I place it here, we don't. What if we place it here? Okay, okay, yes, yes. Maybe with some better footpaths we can achieve that. Who knows, who knows. But okay, let's put it here. And then we will think about the rest. Let's put footpaths with lamps. Why not, right? Can you connect here? Oh, come on. How stupid. I can see that it can get there, but it cannot make the turn probably at the end. Okay, okay, comrade Kirill. In a bit. Maybe if we delete this building and then we can rebuild it. Would that be a solution to this predicament here? No. Ah, yeah. Okay. Perfect. Do we have now? Yes. Everyone is connected, which is great. Great, great, great. Okay. Oh. Oh. One moment, please. Okay. Maybe that was not what I intended. Can we connect you here? Yes. And then... I don't know, do we have to do anything here anyway? No. Well, sure. Let's remove that. Okay. I guess that's it. Ooh, I don't think I need that many, right? Like, we have patients, 10 patients. Okay, let's go with... so what is it? 30, 25 doctors. So something like one doctor can treat up to 3 patients. Let's keep maximum. Oh, so I can click on workers, but I cannot click on doctors. Does it work? Ah, it works the same for both. That's why. Maximum 10. Yeah. 31. Oh, maybe we can even do it 5. 16. Okay, I think 5 is good for now. I don't think it's a huge problem. All right. The hospital requires an educated workforce of doctors as well as staff with basic education. Plus, a fleet of ambulances to reach citizens who are experiencing medical emergencies. We are going to have to buy hospitals, right? Yeah, hospitals, ambulances. Big ambulance. So what is the difference? Let's see. This one... let's see. So this one is from 58 to 76, 59 to 73, 59 to 98. So this is like the most modern. They're very similar in price. Similar in kilometers per hour as well. So they're in general very similar. This one is a little bit longer. I don't know, man. I will just buy each of them and and go with that. Well done, comrades. With the hospital now operational and equipped with dedicated doctors, staff and ambulances, our citizens can receive timely and quality medical care. I advise you to keep an eye on the health level of our people displayed in bar at the top of the screen, this one here. Monitoring their well-being will allow us to address any potential issues promptly and ensure the continued prosperity and vitality of the Soviet Republic. Great stuff! Okay. Oh, and this is the fire now. There you go. Greetings, I am Fedir Antonov, a chief firefighter of the Soviet Republic. With extensive experience in fire safety and disaster response, this is like a CV. I will be your guide in setting up operational fire stations and implementing effective and effective fire prevention measures. Let's work together to ensure the safety of our people and protect our nation from the threat of fires. Alright. We should build a fire station first, I imagine, Comrade Antonov. Fire stations are vital for safety in the Soviet Republic as they have fire trucks ready to respond quickly to fires. When there is a fire, firefighters rush to the scene to put out the flames, preventing buildings from collapsing and protecting our citizens from harm. Build a fire station. Okay. Very important building. Where are we going to build? I think it has plenty of range, by the way. Ooh, so we have... Let's see, what do we have here? We have fire station, so this is the smallest one, I imagine. Yeah, that one is very, very tiny. Oh, by the way, did we check our hospital, how it looks? Yeah, it looks like a hospital. A medium-sized hospital. I like it. Nice, and this is for the emergency, right? This is supposed to be where the ambulances leave their emergency patients. All right. Ooh, and we have... So, there is an entrance here on the back. Aha, yeah, that's why we have this footpath here. Interesting. Maybe that's also an entrance, and that's why there is a footpath on that side as well. Yeah, yeah. It seems so. Alright, so let's proceed with... Fire station. Where was the fire station? Residential, no. Emergency state. There is heating, waste, electricity... Oh my god. Construction... No. Where is it? Residential. Ah, so it's for a state infrastructure. Interesting. Okay. Fire station. So we have one that requires 40 workers, 50, 30. I think we can go with a small one, like... parking spots for vehicles, 2. Stations for vehicle loading and unloading, 1. I don't think we need the... Okay, but the game instructed us to build the bigger one. So, okay, let's go with the medium-sized fire station. Actually, let's put it here. Boom. Okay, and how does it look? Oh, it has a little tower as well. I love it. Can we go faster? Alright, and we have for space for 4 trucks here. Amazing, we have like the office buildings or whatever building this is, like where the firefighters stay at, and a little tower. Nice, looks awesome, I love it. For a functional fire station, we need fire trucks at the ready, and each fire truck can be effectively operated by a varying number of workers. Okay. At least 2 trucks in fire station, at least 5 firefighters in the station. Okay, so Poland, Czechoslovakia, 58.85, 59.98. 4 meters, 7 meters. This one is faster, this one is slower, but it's 7 tons and has much more power. Let's buy one of each, I guess. So, who is coming to work here? We should be seeing some people, right? Maybe, yeah, I think this person is going to the fire station. Okay, let's see. I'm pretty sure. I don't know if we need that many people though. Manually sent truck to fire. Maybe we can go with 15? 15 should be fine for 2 trucks, I imagine. What a bad luck. It appears a fire has started in one of our buildings, but at least we can witness our new fire trucks in action. Oh yeah, where? Why I don't see it? Where are you going? Aha, oh no, we have a fire here. Go fire truck, save us. Go faster. Okay, they arrived in location. They poured some water and the fire is extinguished. Okay, recently we faced a stroke of bad luck as a building caught fire. However, thanks to our preparations, our firefighters swiftly responded, preventing the fire from spreading further and minimizing damage. Let this incident serve as a reminder of the importance of our vigilance and readiness to ensure the safety and security of the Soviet Republic. Oh! And we finished with the emergency part of the tutorials. Nice! Alright. Now that we have our firefighters here, we have taken care of fire and no building is going to burn, hopefully. Let's see what options we have. So the usual one, demolish, manually send the fire, send fire truck to fire, that one that we already saw. The workers, purchasing vehicles, I don't know what this is. Buildings that can be reached on foot. Okay, that makes sense. This is for what the workers are coming from, I guess, nothing else. Rename the building. Building transparent, call vehicles at home. Change workplace depot for all vehicles, sell all vehicles. Okay. Makes sense. Because I think you cannot demolish it, especially in realistic mode, if you don't sell the vehicles. I think you cannot here neither. Although I might be wrong. Alright. That's it. We have taken care of hospitals and fires. Okay, you know what? I think we might increase this to 10. Our unemployment is very low at the moment. Oh, and we are not researching anything. How weird. Okay. Let's also click this one. Required research. Education for loyal citizens. Railway distribution office. Wow, maybe we should do that one. Yeah. And maximum amount of people on the research. Thank you. What about this one? Also here, we're not researching anything. That's a big mistake. Aren't we supposed to research this? Geological mapping? I think so. Everybody go there, please. Thank you. Ooh, we have even more. There you go. Max 75, 40 or 45, max 75, I don't get it. Okay. Ooh, maybe we can lower this one as well to 30. And here we need the research again. Okay. Now we are going to have geological mapping. I think we have set everything up. We have the research in both buildings, which is great. It's going to take time for sure. And we can continue. Let's see. So I see coal mining. I think this is some kind of a vehicle. Maybe it's going to be vehicle production. I don't quite see what this is, this little picture here. This looks like uranium kind of pellet or something like that, I think. But to be honest, if you ask me, I think we first have to feed our citizens and put some clothing on them, because that looks like clothing production. So let's go with this one, and then at the end we're going to do that one. Basics of agriculture. Set up an agricultural area to farm crops that can be used in food and other industries. Okay. Greetings, comrade. I am Rostya Antonov, again comrade Antonov, a seasoned farmer of the Soviet Republic with Kalust, I don't know how this is pronounced, hands, and a heart deeply connected to the land. I stand as a testament to the resilience of our people. Allow me to illuminate the mechanics of collectivization, a vital step towards a unified and thriving agricultural future for our great nation. Fields are the lifeblood of the Soviet Republic, where sowing and harvesting yield precious crops to feed our citizens. Okay. Place at least 10 fields. Ooh, like our agriculture has to be far away. But first, do you know what else we need? We have very low unemployment, which means we have like 100 workers. And I think that we will need... Oh yeah, look at that. We have plenty of people for the fields, right? So we will need to expand our city as well a little bit. Or actually, let's just follow the objectives. So it says place 10 fields. So I don't think we should place the big ones, considering that we have a number of fields that we have to place, not like a total area or production. Speaking about that, do we see anything here? No, we need geological mapping and then uranium mining techniques, bauxite exploration study. So this is three different research to see all the resources. That's fine. But still, our agriculture has to be further away from the city. Maybe not here, but something like... Yeah, around here. I don't know if water is... No, water is not turned on for this one, so it doesn't matter. Okay, let's put... how are we going to do this? Oh, no. That's not what I intended to do. Let's do it. So, our road is going to be coming from... here. Actually, let's extend the road first. What? Okay. Okay. Okay, let's just make a straight road up to here. What are we going to do now? Now we're going to place 5 fields, right? Small field. Let's place them next to each other. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh no, that last one was very far, so no. And here, and now we're going to turn it around and place that here like that. And boom. Now we can also build a road here, which hopefully... Oh, come on, bro. Come on. That's impossible. No. It's unacceptable. Please? Come on. Why you don't want to let me place my roads, Baron? Oh, I saw some green. I saw it. Okay, so if you don't want this to happen to you, put first the road and then add your fields. There we go. All right, what did our guy said? Build a farm. Ooh, I didn't read his instructions, but that's all right. Okay, we need to build a farm. Small farm. Okay, so now we have to make some calculations, right? Like 10 crops. I don't know how much they are producing. Does it say here? No, it just says field size 0.39 hectares. Stations for vehicle loading and unloading. Yeah, that doesn't help much. 10 tons of crops. Do I just trust the senor, comrade Antonov that he knows how much we are going to need? Okay, let's build this here. Now, one thing for sure is that we are going to need for citizens a bus platform. So let's put it here. Like this, and then we can start putting our farms or whatever. I think it should be around here, but both of the connections are on the other side. Okay, this is not what I need. Can we maybe do it like this? Yeah, I think so. I think that's better. I like it like that more. No, I need that other button. There is one. Mirror building, rotate building. No, left control. Yeah, I think that's it. I cannot do much more than that. Well, it's going to be like this. Let's put it here. It's connected to the road. First by extending the road and then connecting to the road. Ooh. The fire station now is probably too far. We'll see, we'll see. Basics of agriculture. Ensure every field is connected to the farm. How? Connected how? No tractors available to sow and fertilize. No vehicles available to harvest. Then fields assigned to farm. Minimum fertility, 50%. Ooh. Tractors in the farm, combines. I don't... am I missing, like, the instructions of the guy? I don't see them. Anyway. Okay, so. Purchase vehicle or mechanism. Tractors, combines, and cover trucks. Okay, that's a tractor. Let's see. Show all sowing. Tractor. Okay. Harvesting, combine, covered her. Let's take the big one, I guess. 70, 62, but this one can carry more. One out of one. Liquid fertilizer increases the yield of your fields. Liquid fertilizer is spread using tractors after fields are sowed. So that means we have to buy, purchase, or deliver liquid fertilizer to the farm. Yeah, so that's something that we need to do. Now, I have a... So this is 35 tons, which is pretty good. I think we can go with that. Where is the distribution office? No, that's a vehicle depot. Wait, what? Ah, there is the distribution office. So, I want to add new connection. This baby here. For unloading, not of crops. I cannot... unload. Ah, I don't have an oil tank. That's why. Oil tank. Bitumen liquid fertilizer. Yep. And this one can carry 11, 7, 3.6. I think we can go with 11 because it was something like 35, right? So we can keep it at 30%. Is that the one that we need? Liquid fertilizer. No, it's this one, I think. Liquid fertilizer, yes. And here you're going to unload liquid fertilizer. Perfect. When it's less than 30% and it's already going to deliver liquid fertilizer. Yeah, awesome. You see, distribution offices, I love them. Okay, and we also, do we need something else? No, we have a garbage container. Oh, so garbage is turned on. That's very interesting. Purchase or deliver liquid fertilizer. Okay, we are going to do that. A field has low fertility. Which one? Can we see? Ah, we already sowing here. Nice, nice. I think we can buy... Purchase or deliver liquid... Yes, 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 relax. We can buy more. One more tractor. And one more combine, I guess. For us to have... more vehicles working on the fields at the same time. Let's also increase the speed here. So we had two connections to this farm. I have an export of crops of 40 tons, which I think is fine. It's plenty of space. So maybe I will not even connect it to like a storage or anything like that. Could be. I don't know how much they actually produce these fields. We shall see. Minimum fertility 50%. Okay, we will bring the fertilizer and everything is going to be all right. One other thing. Do we need to bring workers now? I don't get it. I don't understand. Workers on this field. Maybe workers are needed when you don't have machinery? I have to read about that, to be honest. Because I don't know if he explained it. Because we also missed some of his instructions. Actual nutrient level. Aha! 80%, 28. Oh, so they're pretty bad, right? Do you see, like... information about that? No, you don't. Before you place the field. Interesting. It would be nice if they actually add this to the game. Sowing, growing, harvesting, actual nutrient level. Harvested crops ready to transport 0 tons. Cool, cool. So if I'm very curious, if seasons are not enabled, do you just harvest and grow and so whatever you want? It's a very interesting question. There is our fertilizer. We are. Relax. There you go. So at least 10 fields. Okay, we are going to take some time to do that, I think. Well, I guess a bigger farm does this faster, right? Parking spots. Oh yeah, because we built actually the smallest one. The medium one has twice the amount of vehicles. And the large farm, 5 times the amount of vehicles. Ooh, very big. And also has, that's probably for the fertilizer, right? An input on the top. And many, 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 many connections. Okay. Good to know. So small farms, I guess don't build them unless you have less than 10 of those, I think. I don't know. I don't know what the best solution to this problem would be. Because I don't know. Not much time has passed, actually. So let's let the machines do their job. Okay, are we... Everything is alright with this field. It requires workers with mechanism to harvest. Field has low fertility. Yeah, but that's going to increase with the fertilizer that we brought. We have already used some. By the way, I think my... assign a new... Aha! So it can auto-search. Ah, there is the fields that we have assigned here. Assign distribution offices. Awesome. Awesome. So you can see all the information here that you need. Obviously, you have the warehouses and everything. Curious if we are going to have a problem with that, because I have no idea if we have to take care of this now or not. Here you have all the fields that are assigned to the farm. You can auto-search. Change order. What does that do? Mm-hmm. Aha. Okay, I see. So you can change the priority of certain fields when they're sold or harvested. You can manually assign fields, auto-search fields, up to a range. 500, okay. What is the smallest range? 100 meters. Can you click? Oh, you can also click. Oh, that's amazing. Okay. And assigned distribution offices and all related vehicles as well. I'm pretty sure that we are bringing more fertilizer already. All right. Are we sowing? No, we are just growing it. Or okay, okay. That's pretty cool. That's going to take some time, I'm pretty sure, by the way. Speaking about that, I am rethinking the situation. I think I want to put a larger farm here. Can I just delete it? Can demolish some vehicles or have this building as their home or workplace. Sell those vehicles or move them to a different workplace first. Okay, that's what we're going to do very quickly. I'm going to pause. Sell all vehicles. Yes. Demolish. Yes. Also demolish this road. Like that. And now we are going to build a bigger farm. A medium farm. Yeah, I don't think this is the best. What about this? This is much better, I think. Okay, let's put it here. Okay, and we have 10 fields. So, let's see what we're going to do. Maybe 5. 5 of each, but I have 12, right? Okay, let's see. Sowing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Harvesting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're going to have covered health 2 of those. Maybe I can take one smaller one actually. Yeah, I think so. So let's also buy something smaller. Where is it? Crops 3, 10, 5, 7. Okay, let's do 7. Like this. Alright, and they are already on their way, working again. We are already growing photographs, workers, some mechanisms to harvest. Oh, so we haven't sold there yet. You see, that's the thing. If you have a smaller farm, it's going to take much longer if you have multiple fields operating on one farm. So, you need more farms. There you go, 12. I think 12 is a very good size now for this. Oh, but now I have to also add the distribution, right? Yep, yep. Distribution. The previous one is deleted probably, yes. So, let's add. Where is the farm? Boom. Unload fertilizer. And now it should be going immediately, right? Yeah, there it is. There it is. These guys are delivering everything here. I think I'm not purchasing anything anymore automatically, right? No, not here. Neither here. Everything is delivered by that. Oh, all right, comrades. The seeds are in the ground and now we wait for the harvest. Remember, together we will make these fields flourish. And the Soviet Republic will thrive. When the time comes, the cover trucks will swiftly collect the crops and bring them back to the farm. Keep working hard, for prosperity awaits us all. Oh, okay. I guess that was it. Food industry. Clothing industry. Well, I think we can proceed with food industry then. Right? Yeah, why not? Set up an industry to produce food and alcohol from crops. Greetings, comrade. I am Stanislav Sergeyev, one of the driving forces behind the industrialization of food and alcohol manufacturing in our great Soviet Republic. I stand ready to guide you through the crucial mission of setting up our production of food and alcohol to ensure a steady supply of sustenance and spirits for our citizens. Together, we shall fortify our nation's prosperity and witness the fruits of our labor fueling the strength of the Soviet Republic. Right. The food factory stands as a pivotal site in the Soviet Republic, where harvested crops are efficiently processed, transforming raw produce into essential foodstuffs for our citizens. Okay. Build a food factory. Well, that one is definitely going to need workers. So I don't know if I want to put it right here. and then deliver the workers, or we can put it there. Interesting, right? So, maximum number of workers 170, maximum production per workday 20 for 42 crops. Environment pollution. Also, that one actually pollutes. Maybe we should keep it here far from the citizens, right? Stations for vehicle loading and unloading 2. And we have a warehouse import 72 tons of crops, which is alright. And an export of 25 tons of food. Okay. Let's put it here, but let's connect it to the farm. Let's see how we're going to do this. Something like that. Or we can put it here as well. Yeah, that makes sense as well, when we can add our vault on the other side. Wait, what if I do this? And do it like that. That also works, I guess. Yeah, yep. Yeah, if I add it like this, it's going to be closer to the... Yeah, I think it's going to be here. Now we can add the road. Here, and like that. And we can also add a footpath over here. Can we? Yeah, that's perfect. Okay, we built the food factory. I should also establish passengers, right? But let's first read what Comrade Stanislav Sergeyev has to say. The distillery is a vital facility in the Soviet Republic that efficiently converts surplus crops into valuable alcohol. It plays a crucial role in bolstering our economy. Okay, build a distillery. Now, if I want to also build a distillery connected to the crops... Let's see if we can make it alcohol. Yeah, but it has to be here somewhere, I imagine. Yep. Can we... What happens if we do this? Oh, yeah. I think that works as well. And then maybe I can have... No, but this is fine, I imagine. Like this. Okay. Boom. And we will automatically get the crops from both buildings. And these guys have a connection as well to here. I don't like it though much. I would have loved. You can expand the factory's internal storage by connecting a warehouse to it via its factory connection. Yes, yes, I'm aware. Excellent work, comrade. With the food factory and distillery already in place, the objective is clear. Produce and set amount of food and alcohol to bolster our nation's prosperity and provide for our citizens. Your dedication to this task will undoubtedly contribute to the strength and well-being of the Soviet Republic. Let's get to work and ensure our targets are met efficiently. 30 tons of food, 20 tons of alcohol. Oh yeah, eventually when we have finished the growing process. Okay, for now, there is something that has to be done here, and that is to connect... passenger station, bus platform, small, bus platform, big one. Yeah, I think this one is, which is the biggest one? Aha, okay, I think that's the one that we want. Okay, something like this works for me. Yeah, we can even connect it here. Awesome. One thing that I think the game does not support, unfortunately, is footpaths across the factory connections. Yeah, it's very sad. Very upsetting. I do have, I'm pretty sure though, overpass. Can I build an overpass around here somehow? Pedestrian bridge. Pedestrian bridge. Underpass. Maybe an underpass. That's the entrance from this side. What is it? No, okay. Come on, overpass. Pergola, pergola. Overpassed you. I don't think it matters at this moment. Okay, let's try to do it. Let's see if it's going to work. I kind of doubt it, but who knows? I might be surprised by myself. So we can add it here like this. And then breach. Maybe I should add one on the other side first. Aha! Aha! There you go. Boom. And now we can add this one here. Yay! You see? It works. It's so cool. I love it. This is so socialist republic, man. Food production. I am Borislav Fedorov, the Minister of Transportation of the Soviet Republic. As a seasoned logistic expert, I oversee the smooth movement of resources throughout our nation. If you find yourself short on crops for the food factory or distillery, you have two options. You can purchase the necessary crops directly from the buildings themselves, click on the building and use the icon in the top of the window, or you can have them delivered yourself, first build or select a road vehicle's depot and purchase a cover truck there by clicking on the icon at the bottom of the window, then open the window on the vehicle and set up a route from the building where the crops are located to the food factory distillery where they are. Yeah, sure. Remember, a well-planned transportation network is the backbone of a thriving economy. Plan wisely and watch our nation flourish. Sure. Now, unemployed workers, 2%. This is pretty bad, right? We need to start expanding the city as well. So, I need to build... These ones are almost ready for harvest. By the way, what happened? We do have liquid fertilizer. Okay. Now it's 60 tons, so it's going to bring when it's less than 20. Interesting. Are we bringing now? We should be bringing now, right? Yes, we are bringing now. We have 11 tons and we are coming back. Okay. So. Purchase a vehicle. Prison bus, no. Where is it? Bus. And let's bring a big bus. Total capacity. 80 passengers. Yeah, let's take a super big one. And set this boy to take people from here back to here. And I don't think you should load back here, right? They're going to teleport. You will see. Start. Okay. Now that we did that, there is a few things we have to do, students. Oh, we finished with our research. Okay, I guess I missed that part. Let's do the bauxite part as well. Maximum amount of researchers. And what about this one? High ranking members, tourism, fire prevention, containers. Prioritizing high ranking members. Okay, let's do the fire prevention first. Let's build... I actually have to do something which I totally forgot. Bro, I understood. Get fucked. Something that I absolutely forgot, and that is that we need a closed sports center as well. Beach, outdoor swimming pool, something like that. Can I somehow, yeah, and also be able to add a building there of the same type? That would be great. It was this one, right? I don't want the road connection. I don't really care about it. So we can put it as close as possible here too. Maybe if I flip it. Like that. Okay. And now if I am going to be able to put the sports, the swimming pool. Oh, it's a stretch. It's a stretch, but it might work. But I will be out of, I will be out of paths for sure. What if I put it here at the end? I think it's still going to have connection to everyone. Okay, let's extend our footpaths. on my new building. Oh, come on, game, sometimes. What, this is part of the building here? Is that the problem? Seriously, sometimes. Oh, right, seriously, man. What the hell is this? No, that's not... That's a waste of space. Okay, that's better. Here we can connect like that. Okay, and we can also extend this one up to here. And maybe now, if that fits here, I can try to place it. Yeah, I don't think so. Why is it so big, man? Bro, seriously. I can put it here, but then there is no more buildings to be added here. Do we have a smaller one? Outdoor, swimming pool, beach. No, everything else is open. City stadium. Oh, that's too big. Well, I should have left more space between the buildings, but... Okay, you know what? We are just going to... I don't think seasons are turned on, so it doesn't matter, maybe. I think they're getting enough sports as it is. Okay, do we have people working here already? Yes, we have. But our unemployment is 3%, which means that we are lacking workers. I can tell you that much for sure. Okay, we got some here. That's great. Oh, we also don't have space for citizens, it appears. I can actually take some people and add them to the halls of residence. Let's take... University, no, I don't want people with university education. There's no such citizens in this building, okay. There you go. Let's relocate everyone who... Yeah. There you go. Now we have some space in our buildings, which is great. We can get some more people. I also have to build more... for sure, more residential buildings. And I think I want something larger. Yeah, that's not very large. But it houses 157 people. And these are low quality, 89, yeah, I know, 50, 87, and that's one is 68. Like, this is literally the best one because everything else is houses too few people. So we are going to continue until we have some research here. I have to find which research is that. And we are going to make a second district on this side here. Ooh, and also, let's not get citizens. I will do that after. They do have access to the rest of the buildings here, which is great. So I think for this new setup, we're not going to need... Let's actually first add the footpath. Something like that. I like it. Yep. Okay. And now we can build more residential buildings here. Let's go. Let's, we can add something here, which is awesome. Maybe we can add another playground, maybe. Where was that? There is an accessories, right? Yeah. Bigger playground, maybe? That's the big one. Right? This is small, medium, large. Let's add it here. We can also add some monuments, of course. A Lenin statue. This is green, right? Yes. And that's good for now. Also, a few more buildings here on that side. I don't need the connection, to be honest. We can even turn them around like this. Oh, I would love though to have... I actually have to change something. I have to change this one to be that one. Can I... How do I remove it? No. Bro, I want this one to be here, not the other one. How do you remove it? Bro, stop speaking to me. I don't need your advice. Yeah, let's have that connection here. This is already connected, so that's all right. Maybe that's fine. I think it's fine. We need to get immigrants. Oh, we are actually getting some people with higher education as well. And our unemployment is going to rise for sure. I'm pretty sure, but we were going to see that with time. And this has access to everyone, which is absolutely fantastic. We have more people now. No resources, missing crops. Okay, growing progress, harvesting. Oh, we are already harvesting, right? We should be seeing some crops here. There you go. We are seeing some crops. Crops, crops. Current production. There you go. Just in time. I came back here just in time. Okay, the other thing that we have to do, I think, is... maybe I should have... Yeah, I think I can add these guys to the distribution office. These two buildings. So it's going to be this and that. So that we can start producing them and move forward with the objective. 64. Let's do it at 20% maybe. Actually, maybe even... less than a 10% storage percent. No, actually I need it to be, yeah, 10% is fine. If it's lower than 10%, go for crops. And I think I should buy one more of those trucks here. Show all engine name type capacity. No, I don't know what, who carries crops. It's a covered hull. Okay, so covered hull. Let's buy another one. Okay, that's fine. We have some crops, we have some production. Things are looking nice. We have... it's going up and down, which means that some people are finding jobs, which is great because we have the food factor, which needs 170,500 people. I think I added that much, maybe. I don't know, 6 buildings of more or less. Ooh, university education, nice. Cool stuff. Okay, we have some people here as well. Are we researching? We are not researching. Maybe the prefab stuff, right? Where is it? Let's see. I have no... ah. Concrete utilization study... prefab panel construction. There you go. So it's concrete utilization. There you go. Investigation into the potential use of concrete in prefab panels for faster construction. This study will also explore the use of concrete in specific large structures such as monuments. There you go. Let's go. Maximum. I don't understand. It says max 75, but says also 38 out of 40, 40 out of 45. Not quite sure what that is and why it's doing it. What about this one? Okay. Tourism, no. Let's do this one. Begins exploration of how to best support and enhance the lives of our most loyal party members. Okay. How are we doing here? Not great. Maybe I actually have to buy more. Yeah. I think I should buy more buses for this. Auto capacity. Let's buy two more, I guess. And how do you do this now? The copy schedule? No. New stop. Can we assign you set line? This one. Set line. This one. Start. Start. Okay. And that's it. Now we should have number of passengers. Where do you want to go, guys? I have no idea. What's your plan here? Number of workers waiting. We still have a bunch of workers waiting. All related vehicles. Yeah, related lines. Does the game support line detail? Line spacing is disabled. Line spacing is enabled. There you go. I want to space the line. I think that means that the buses are going to come in specific intervals. 80 workers. There you go. 20 tons of food and 8 tons of alcohol. Missing crops. So we haven't delivered crops yet here. My distribution office is just waiting. Crops, can you deliver unload crops in the distillery and the food factory? No idea why it's complaining. Maybe because it's connected to the... I want to see the deliveries, if that's okay. Why am I not seeing the deliveries? Interesting. Ooh, by the way, I have to start delivering the food as well. Interesting how we're going to do this. Okay, I have to think about it. Maybe I should deliver... I should have another distribution office here. Right? I should really learn where the distribution of... distribution, okay. I don't need a free one. I can take a small one. And add it here. Ugh, that was ugly. Yes. And add it here, okay. And this distribution office is going to be... I will buy a covered hull for the food and the alcohol. But I just care about the food, I guess. The alcohol, I think I'm going to export. So I'm going to buy... a big one. Does it make sense? 6.5. Yeah, let's buy two. We're going to add. So, load. No, load. Alcohol. When the storage percentage is at 10%. And you are going to unload here the alcohol. And it should start moving immediately, right? That's my understanding. Yes. So when it's at 10%, 10%, no. That means it's... because it can house much more, the truck. It can get how much alcohol? 6.5. So it's like 40%. Yeah, at 40%. So 40%. And for this one is... how much food can you get? Ah, the other one is also coming, you see? Food is 6.5 as well. So for the food, we are going to go at 25%. Yeah, makes sense. Add this one. No. Can I move you up? Remove this connection. Change order. Yeah, I want the food to be here. And I want this to be loading. Food. But can I set percentage here as... Yes, 25. Perfect. Okay, 40, 25. Perfect, perfect, perfect. So now it should work as intended, I think. And it's going to unload the food. Here. When the storage percentage is 10 food, right? That's the point. Yeah. Okay. And after you do this, if there is more food, you can deliver it there. We already have it, actually. But this one, of course, has to be prioritized to be last. So you can also take food there. I think that's going to work as I expect it to work, meaning that it's first going to take food to the to here and to the shopping center. And only if the shopping center is full, it's going to export the food. Now, I want to change this as well here for the food. Storage percentage 10. Right, so it's going to bring stuff if the storage percentage is 10 or lower. I think that's how it works. Yes, exactly. And at the same time, a shopping center can take how much? 14 tons. Yeah, you see, that's the problem. If it was a warehouse, it's so much easier to do this. So always try to connect these things to a warehouse because it's so much easier to set up the distribution. All the crops that we took are already used. Now the question is, do I get crops at all from the distribution center? No, because I didn't set load crops. And there you go, now it's going to start going for the crops. I think I have to buy more of those guys. It's not going. Ah, it's going. Okay. And now we're going to see more crops being delivered here. We're already sowing, which is great. And the other machines are going as well. To be honest, I think I could have put this farm somewhere here. Or the farm has to be here, the crops extending from the farm, and then the farm being connected to the warehouse, and this guy's also being connected to a warehouse. That would make things much, much easier for calculations, because you see now our warehouse export. Okay. We're still very low in unemployment. Should we invite a few more immigrants here and there? What about our research? Oh, we finished our research. Prefab construction and go. Maximum. And here we are researching as well. Okay, come on. Now we have to start seeing the crops. This is going to take a while, probably. Okay, we have one here that is resting, which maybe makes sense. Ah, no, that's the meat one. Okay, so I should probably buy even more covered cows. Yeah. Because it's a long distance, you know, it takes time. This one is not going, which is fine. Like, as long as we have one that is just waiting there, we are doing great. We still have a lot of workers waiting here. Honestly, maybe even more buses are necessary here. Yeah, I think so. Purchase bus capacity. Let's assign these guys to that line. Go. Set that line. Go. Because also the citizens, they have a maximum amount of waiting that they're going to do, and we don't want that to be reached before we pick them up if they are going to go to work somewhere, because that means that we're not going to have the production that we want in our factories. Can we extend them a footpath here of some kind? No, because I built this too close, I guess. Yeah, that's not gonna work. Nope. It's unfortunate. Maybe on the other side? Oh yeah, with a little... Well, while I'm waiting for things, why don't we do that, actually? We have an overpass concrete. Like this. And then we can put it here as well. Beautiful. And then we can continue this like that. And this connection here can go. Sorry, guys. Sorry. Don't hate me. What? What? Okay. This one. Hey, don't tell me that. There you go. I'm pretty sure now they're going to start taking the footpath. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Ooh, so good. So good. I love it. I enjoy so much these overpasses. I think I'm going to place them everywhere. Oh, oh, why? This is weird. Well, we're going to have to take that loss. I think we're going to start having more people here. I wish we had more crops as well. I think I'm not delivering enough crops. And still this guy waiting for medium distribution office. Maybe you can have maximum one truck delivering stuff. Does that mean that... Yeah, because I think this is crops, yeah. But I think he's going to use them much faster than I can actually deliver the new ones, right? So if you do this by trains, that will be much, much more efficient. Well, I'm soon going to make the 20 tons anyway. Maybe we can expand this process a little bit by doing the following thing. Covered how? Big one. Okay. Take this boyo. And we're going to set a line for him. New stop. Customs house. So no distribution office included in the picture. Where is my... And then go here. In the customs office, you're going to load crops. And here you're going to unload crops. And you're also going to load alcohol. Right? And here you're going to unload the alcohol. So we basically did this without a distribution office. We're going to open this. Yeah. We're going to purchase a few more. We're going to delete. Close that. And then we're going to copy. To this. Okay. Oh, no, I should not have done that. Well, let's go back here. And now just start these boys. And now they're going to be supporting the... the alcohol production much better, I think. It's a very, very long way. It's like 3 kilometers or something, I think. So definitely it takes them some time to deliver all the crops, but that's all right. And later, if I find the... Maybe that's a better way to do it if you're going to do it like that. And but you have to find the equilibrium so that you don't have too many trucks or too few trucks. Oh, you see, we have enough workers now. We're still at 1%, which means that we can add many more people if we're going to work. This is the maximum capacity. And we should do the same for the food factory, but I don't want to do it now, for now. Maybe I can do it in the next episode. First, I want to see... this guy delivered crops, right? Yeah. But they finish so quickly, man. They are so... That's the thing. This one consumes... it can produce... What is it? 20 tons of food per day with 42 tons of crops. That's per work day. Is that for everybody or for one... Per one worker? I'm failing to understand. Ah, there you go. Mission accomplished, comrade. Your hard work has paid off, and the specified quotas for food and alcohol have been met. The Soviet Republic citizens will be well fed and have access to essential spirits. Your dedication has furthered our nation's growth and prosperity. Keep up the excellent work for a higher future ahead. Oh, there you go. We finished it. Awesome. I just want to check if just to have for the next episode some research set up already. Grant monuments. Cars, education, air traffic, tourism, fire prevention, interesting, okay. Loyal party members should be given preferential access to higher education. This study will let us set a low threshold for university admissions. Aha, you see, that's the one that we were needing, so let's add this one. Okay, let's increase the maximum. Let's research everything as quickly as possible. And here, alright, we should have durable prefab panels. Development of multi-story buildings using prefab panels. This will allow the construction of buildings with 8 or more floors, conserving urban space. Yeah, that's definitely something that we need. Let's add more. Perfect. Okay. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. With this comes the end of today's episode, guys. What do you think of the campaign so far? And all the things that we did in this episode? Let me know in the comment section below. Also, don't forget to smash the like button and click the subscribe with notifications turned on. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.